Emergency crews to stations.
Get back to Tanaka. Tell him to come here with every man he's got.
Yes.
From James Bond movies to The Incredibles, the notion of secret dwellings inside mountains has captured imaginations for decades. But 50 years ago in Scotland, a power company decided that they could use the inside of one particular mountain for a very different kind of use. Roxana Saberi went to Scotland to find out more.
Beside the clear waters of a Scottish lake known as Loch Awe, soars Ben Cruachan, a mountain rising to over 3,500 feet, masking a marvel of engineering.
It does look very James Bond-ish.
We traveled through a tunnel over a half a mile long to emerge in a turbine hall carved into rock. Buzzing with machinery, this is the heart of a hydroelectric plant that engineer Ian Kinnard says points to the future of renewable energy.
8.3 gigawatts of storage energy is a maximum. To put that in context, that's probably equivalent to about 145,000 Tesla Model 3s sitting fully charged. That's how much energy we store.
Who calculated that?
That energy comes from water, 1,300 feet up the mountain.
Can you explain where we are up here? What is
this? Absolutely. So, in front of you, you have Cruachan Reservoir, which is held back by Cruachan Dam.
Sarah Cameron, who manages a nearby visitor center, says the reservoir fills up with rain and water pumped up from Loch Awe. When the water is released from the reservoir, it flows down to the power plant and through the force of gravity turns its turbines.
So it's a cycle.
It is a cycle,
pump
exactly.
Up, pump out.
Absolutely.
When demand for energy goes up, these turbines kick into high gear. Within 30 seconds, they can provide enough electricity to power 800,000 homes. Compare that to coal-fired plants, which can take hours to spark to life. The UN says globally, hydropower supplies around 17% of electricity, though it makes up much less in the UK and the US. Some environmentalists say it's needed to help the world transition to renewable energy. But they add, dams can disrupt wildlife. The team at Cruachan says it's tried to minimize any impact by blending into the landscape as much as possible and by using screens to prevent marine life from being sucked from the reservoir.
How well it merited royal inauguration. A pull of the lever and the great machines were turning, generating power for the industrial lowlands.
A celebrated feat of construction that started in 1959, it took around 4,000 workers 6 years to build Cruachan.
You can still see some of the boreholes from where they drilled and blasted.
Next year, the British company Drax hopes to begin excavating an estimated 2 million more tons of rock to expand the plant.
You know, it's testament to those that built it back in the late 1950s and early 60s. You know, 60 years later, we're still operating this plant, and it's more needed than ever before.
They say to help Scotland wean itself off of fossil fuels, they're ready to move mountains again. For CBS Saturday Morning, Roxana Saberi, Argyle, Scotland.
So cool.
Yeah.
Very cool. I just say that? Cool.
And nice last lines, Roxana. I like that last line.
And great name of the town, Argyle. Yeah.
And great accent. I almost got a little lost in the accent where I was like, wait, pay attention.
Yeah. Very interesting.
Yeah.